following a little footpath through some rejuvenated woodlands high above Loch Hoon in the Western Highlands. It's been originally an oak wood, but I have to say that it seems that the birch and the bracken has rejuvenated much, much better than the oak, although there is some quite pleasant oak still around, still looking fairly healthy. This is the start to walk. It's a steep start to walk up onto a ridge, which is going to take me up onto one of my favourite mountains on the Western Highlands, a mountain that has resonances of the works of a writer who inspired me greatly many, many years ago to pack in my job and come and live in the Highlands. The mountain is Ben Screeul. The writer I was referring to, of course, was the great Gavin Maxwell. And Gavin Maxwell came to this area of the Western Highlands and settled at a place called Sandake Bay, which he referred to as Camasfuerna, the Bay of the Alders. It's not very far from here, just down at the foot of the hill. And of course, it was there he wrote some of his great books, including his study of wild otters in Ring of Bright Water, a book that inspired me and probably thousands like me. It also became quite a well-known film. But I always like to come up to Ben Screeul here and kind of consider this mountain as a living memorial to Gavin Maxwell. And I think that's, I don't know, I think it sort of stands for much more than any plaque or any stone memorial down by the roadside. Ben Screeul at 974 metres. There are actually two tops to Ben Screeul, the other one slightly further east, and that's the route that we take to go down into Arnisdale. It's a long descent down quite a lot of squeeze slopes, but that takes you down to Arnisdale, and then there's a walk back along the road to where we left our car. It is a terrific mountain. The weather's just beginning to change. I've got some mist and cloud just rolling in now, but you know, when it's clear, as it was all the way up, you can see across Loch Hoon to the big hills of Knoydart, Larvin, Lunavin, way across to Scornachies, and then of course just slightly further north, all the hills of Glenshiel, and you can see the hills of Skye today as well. So it really is a terrific mountain, and I think a very worthwhile memorial to that great writer, Gavin Maxwell.